Thank you. As the parade of graduates approaches, we salute the states and territories whose sons and daughters will graduate today. Delaware, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Georgia, Connecticut, Massachusetts, Maryland, South Carolina, New Hampshire, Virginia, New York, North Carolina, Rhode Island, Vermont, Kentucky, Tennessee, Ohio, Louisiana, Indiana, Mississippi, Illinois, Alabama, Maine, Missouri, Arkansas, Michigan, Florida, Texas, Iowa, Wisconsin, California, Minnesota, Oregon, Kansas, West Virginia, Nevada, Nebraska, Colorado, North Dakota, South Dakota, Montana, Washington, Idaho, Wyoming, Utah, Oklahoma, New Mexico, Arizona, Alaska, Hawaii, District of Columbia, Puerto Rico, Guam, American Samoa, Northern Mariana Islands, U.S. Virgin Islands. State flags, order, arms. And now, we invite you to join the staff of Recruit Training Command in welcoming the graduating divisions with your applause as they enter Midway Ceremonial Drill Hall and are announced in the following order.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise as we welcome today's graduating divisions. Division 004. Today's graduating performing unit is Division 901 and 902. Division 901 provides the state flag, color guard, and drumline units. 902 provides the recruit choir, drill team, and band for today's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Thank you. Divisions. Right. Face. Section leaders. Fall out and collect outer garments.
Thank you. close interval. Dress right. Dress. Ready. Front. Right. Face. Parade. Rest.
May I have your attention, please? For the remainder of the review, no one will be permitted to pass in front of the review stand, and we ask this as a courtesy to our reviewing officers. Photography is certainly encouraged, but we ask that you remain seated and off the drill deck. The photographers you will see on deck throughout the review are the official photographers of Recruit Training Command. Division commanders, left or right, face, parade, rest.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I'm Lieutenant John Godfrey, Recruit Training Command's Master of Ceremonies. I'd like to welcome you to today's pass and review. Today, you will see eight divisions comprised of 723 sailors, participating in their graduation ceremony and soon to join the most powerful Navy in the world. Please draw your attention to the unit positioned at center deck. There is the review commander and staff. The review commander is responsible for conducting the graduation ceremony. Today's review commander is Seaman Recruit Kendall Jarvis from Los Gatos, California. Let's give him a hand, folks. Performing today is the Staff Unit on their 8th week of training, the Triple Threat and State Flags Unit on their 10th and final week of training. These units are comprised entirely of recruits. During their night of arrival, recruits are placed in the divisions of 88 personnel and assigned division commanders. Recruit division commanders form the backbone of recruit training and are key individuals in the life of every recruit. Division commanders must serve as counselors, disciplinarians, administrators, and military leaders. Above all, they must show themselves as outstanding examples of military bearing, appearance, attitude, and behavior. Each division also has a recruit chief petty officer. This senior recruit supervises the divisional staff positions and leads the division in the absence of their division commanders. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce the graduating divisions, their division commanders, and recruit chief petty officers. As I introduce each division, they will raise the competitive flags that they have earned throughout their training. As I introduce each recruit chief petty officer, the flag representing their home state will also be raised. Please hold your applause until all introductions have been completed. I will be starting from their right. Division 001, commanded by Chief Petty Officer Summer Cates. Petty Officer First Class Brady Ching. Petty Officer First Class Bao Vu. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Apprentice Devin Davis from San Antonio, Texas. Division 002, commanded by Chief Petty Officer Leland Kuhn. Petty Officer First Class Anthony Douglas. first class, Christy Jones. And their recruit chief petty officer, Fireman Austin Rinke from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Division 003. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Mary Namani. Petty Officer Second Class Gino Bono. Petty Officer Second Class Thomas Lopez. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Airman Apprentice Marcella Torres from Topeka, Kansas. Division 004. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Antonio Olmos. Petty Officer First Class Lucas Kiley. Petty Officer Second Class Kathy Garcia. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Apprentice Julia Vega Myers from Marietta, Georgia. Division 005. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Jason Brownlee. Petty Officer First Class LaMarcus Seabury. Petty Officer First Class Alexander Ayono. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Airman Valdemar Hernandez from Crosby, Texas. Division 006. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Salteria Robinson. Petty Officer First Class Benjamin Page. Petty Officer First Class Raul Garcia Villavicencio. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Apprentice Marcos Martinez from Oxnard, California. Division 901. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Tim Yakovishin. Petty Officer First Class Andrew Reese. Petty Officer Second Class Alma Gallegos. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Apprentice Andrew Murray from Townsend, Massachusetts. Division 902. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Lazarus Bullock. Petty Officer First Class Cody Gaines. Petty Officer Second Class Jennifer Andujar. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Gladys Garcia from Laredo, Texas. On behalf of the commanding officer and staff of Recruit Training Command, we congratulate these division commanders and Recruit Chief Petty Officers on a job well done. See the ceremonial side boys, boatswain, and honor guard take their places for arrival honors. This time honored tradition is our formal greeting to this morning's reviewing officer. When requested by the announcer, please stand for the arrival honors, marching on of the colors, the national anthem, and the invocation. As a reminder, military guests shall remain covered throughout the entire graduation ceremony. And ladies and gentlemen, one final note. As befitting the importance of this occasion, our ceremony is conducted in a formal manner. However, we do encourage you to participate in today's graduation. ceremony by letting your applause show these sailors just how proud of them you are. Once again, welcome aboard.
Divisions, attention!
Will the guests please rise and remain standing for the arrival of the official party?
Time early! Strike four bells!
Recruit Training Command, arriving.
Captain! Honor guard, standing by for inspection! Sir!
And
please rise. Present arms. Order, arms. Chaplain Miller will offer this morning's invocation.
Let us pray. Almighty God, creator of all that is, we thank you that we have the opportunity to come before you today to celebrate the accomplishment of our newest United States Navy sailors. Thank you for the successful completion of boot camp here at Recruit Training Command. We thank you for their families, friends, and mentors who have encouraged and inspired them to get to this moment. We also thank you for the RDCs, the instructors, facilitators, and staff who have sacrificed greatly and forged each single one of their lives for the past several weeks. These sailors have been tested and tried, and yet through the pressure, they have been transformed into warriors. Now these warriors, these mighty sailors, stand here today with the awesome responsibility on their shoulders that future freedom is dependent on them. And they have a great responsibility to their families, their country, those who have served before them, to the Constitution they swore to defend, the leadership, the world, and future generations. We pray they won't fall to the weight that rests upon them, but they would rise for the tasks that set before them. And we pray that they would be men and women of great character who are confident and tough and always ready to get the mission accomplished as they defend freedom and democracy around the world. So then, as our newest sailors go around the world, who will now be forged by the great sea, may they always be a beacon of hope and light. And Lord, may you always grant them immeasurable courage, unwavering strength, sound guidance, and godly wisdom. But most of all, you remain their spiritual anchors of faith, hope, and love.
and may their lives always reflect the core values and core attributes in everything they do. In your most holy name we pray. Amen.
Present the graduating division. Request permission to commence the review.
Very well, commence the review.
Aye, aye, sir.
Good morning. I'm Commander Rick Jarko, Executive Officer of Recruit Training Command. On behalf of the Commanding Officer, Captain Kirtrick Brooks, I'm pleased to welcome our families and friends to our graduation ceremony, and we look forward to sharing this momentous occasion with you. I have the pleasure today of introducing and recognizing one of the finest Americans that I've had the opportunity to serve with in the United States Navy. And I'd like to recognize him today because this is his last graduation as the Command Master Chief of Recruit Training Command. Not only is he a fine American, he's a fellow submariner, a friend, and an absolute pleasure to work with. So I'd like to ask him to stand up before he heads off to be the Command Master Chief of the USS George H.W. Bush, an aircraft carrier currently on deployment where he will lead sailors doing real-world Navy work right now. I'd like to ask him to stand up and recognize him with me with a round of applause. During Command Master Chief Wallace's time on board, he had the opportunity to lead 75,000 new recruits, new sailors, headed out to the fleet, many of which he will lead again on the warship George H.W. Bush. So thank you, Master Chief, for your service here at Recruit Training Command. Also with us today is our reviewing officer, Captain Omar Martinez, Commander's Action Group, Naval Service Training Command. I cannot thank all of our visitors enough for your continued support, and I'm sure your sailors are grateful for your encouragement throughout their training at Recruit Training Command. I would also like to welcome all the veterans in our audience and thank them for their service to our country. Would all of our veterans please stand up and let's give them a round of applause. Divisions 901 and 902 graduate today. Division 901 is the state flags unit, providing the 50 state flags, District of Columbia and U.S. territory flags, drum corps, and color guard. Division 902 is the triple threat unit, providing recruit choir, drill team, and band. Please join me in giving them and the six other graduating divisions here today a round of applause for their outstanding performances. This is where our Navy heritage meets the future, and where these young men and women enter the profession of arms. The staff of Recruit Training Command is dedicated to providing the United States Navy with basically trained, physically fit, and smartly disciplined sailors, such as those standing here this morning. These sailors have successfully completed 10 weeks of demanding recruit training. They have earned the right to wear the uniform recognized throughout the world as a symbol of freedom. They and others like them serve as the bedrock of our naval forces. They will join other sailors around the world to give our Navy its combat edge and enable us to keep this nation secure. This training group is ready to graduate and serve in the world's most powerful Navy. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you 723 of the newest and sharpest sailors in the United States Navy.
Recruit Training Command's competitive system among individual recruits and divisions promotes teamwork, attention to detail, and pride in accomplishment. Divisions performing above standards throughout their training are awarded recognition flags in the five mission areas: academic achievement, military drill, compartment readiness, applications, and physical fitness. These flags are carried as a visible symbol of the division's success. Each flag indicates that your sailors individually and as teams met performance standards in one or more mission areas. A division that excels in every phase of training qualifies for the Battle Efficiency Honor Division recognition and is awarded the Battle E Honor Flag for this exemplary achievement. Division 0, 05, has earned this honor today, and we congratulate them on a job exceptionally well done.
Hooray! Rats!
Captain Martinez will now present this week's individual awards, and he will be joined on the drill deck by our Executive Officer, Commander Jarkow, and Recruit Training Command's Command Master Chief Wallace. Sponsored by the Lake Defiance Chapter of the Illinois Society of the Sons of American Revolution. Seaman Lee receives a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor. Displayed extraordinary qualities best expressing the American spirit of honor, initiative, and loyalty. Seaman Jeremiah Samples, Division 005 from Newark, Ohio, is awarded the Navy League Award, which is sponsored by the Navy League of the United States. Seaman Samples is presented with a commemorative plaque and a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor! Seaman Apprentice Andrew Murray, Division 901, from Townsend, Massachusetts, is the winner of the United Service Organization Award for best exemplifying the spirit and intent of the word shipping. Seaman Apprentice Murray is given a commemorative plaque from the United Service Organization. Well done, sailor! Seaman Gladys Garcia, Division 902, from Laredo, Texas, is the recipient of the Military Order of the World Wars Award of Merit. This award is presented for meritorious performance during recruit training. Seaman Garcia is presented with a commemorative plaque from the Military Order of the World Wars. Well done, sailor! The Military Officers Association Leadership Award is presented to Fireman Sonic Gray, Division 003, from Pocatello, Idaho, for demonstrating exceptional tenacity and professionalism. Fireman Gray is awarded with a letter of commendation from our commanding officer. Well done, sailor!
Thank you, Captain.
Seaman Apprentice Morgan Jenner, Division 901, from Valley City, North Dakota, is the recipient of the Navy Club of the United States of America Military Excellence Award for best exemplifying the qualities of enthusiasm, devotion to duty, military bearing, and teamwork. This award places her at the pinnacle of today's newest sailors. She is awarded a flag letter of commendation. Seaman Apprentice Jenner, the staff of Recruit Training Command, salutes you as the finest of this group of graduates. Well done, sailor.
Divisions, attention!
It is appropriate to recognize such outstanding individual accomplishments by these sailors with a round of three cheers. The adjutant will lead all graduating divisions in three cheers for this morning's award winners.
Hip, hip.
It's a distinct pleasure this morning of introducing our reviewing officer, Captain Omar Martinez, Commander's Action Group, Naval Service Training Command. A native of Cedar Rapids, Iowa, he enlisted in the United States Navy in 1986 and was commissioned in the Limited Duty Officer Program in 2000. Among Captain Martinez's operational and sea duty assignments are USS Carl Vinson, where he served as Executive Department Head and Admin Officer. Admin Officer on board USS Bonhomme Richard, and Personnel Officer, Admin Officer, and Executive Department Head on board USS Constellation. Prior to his current assignment, he served as Chief of Staff for the Chief of Naval Personnel, Executive Officer, Naval Station Great Lakes, Assistant Chief of Staff at U.S. 3rd Fleet, and Flag Secretary for Commander Naval Forces, U.S. Pacific Fleet. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a warm Recruit Training Command welcome to Captain Martinez.
Good morning, and welcome to all our distinguished guests, and most importantly, the family and friends, these sailors in ranks today. It is a great privilege to join you today to welcome these men and women as the newest sailors in the United States Navy. To all the sailors standing now before me, congratulations on your accomplishments and on your uniforms look magnificent, and I want to personally congratulate and thank each and every one of you that has earned the title of United States Sailor. In 1986, over 36 years ago, I put on a Navy uniform, and like you, I made the choice to enter the profession of arms and of service to our great nation. Each of you has selflessly answered the call to duty, to serve a cause greater than yourselves. You have passed every test, triumphed over every challenge, and proven yourselves worthy of wearing the uniform that symbolizes freedom throughout the world, the uniform of the United States Navy. Whether you stay for 4 years or for 30 years, you have joined an exclusive organization of those who have chosen the path of service I call the greatest Navy in the world. To all the families and friends of these sailors, you have played a vital role in helping to shape them into a person who chose to serve their country and to understand the Navy's core values of honor, courage, and commitment. You have supported your sailor over the past 10 weeks, and in a few minutes from now, you'll see your sailor that embodies our Navy ethos and demonstrates warrior toughness. Your sailor will continue to rely on your love and support wherever the Navy takes them. We also now welcome you into the Navy family. Welcome aboard. To the leadership at Recruit Training Command, from the ship's officers to the recruit division commanders to the civilian staff, thank you. Thank you for your continued commitment to excellence in our nation's maritime strategy by training and sending the absolute best, most qualified sailors to the fleet. Please join me in a special round of applause for the staff of Recruit Training Command. Sailors, I can tell you from experience that you are about to embark on one of the most challenging adventures of your life. But I can also tell you that if you serve with honor, you keep faith with your fellow shipmates, commitment, and strive for excellence in everything you do, it will also be one of the most rewarding. You've chosen to serve your country at a time when you are most needed, when America must show a strong presence throughout the world, on the seas, on the ground, and in the skies. And when you leave this drill hall, please know that your journey will continue, and you will continue to grow as a United States sailor, and the only thing you'll leave behind at Great Lakes is a little bit of your heart. Yes, that's correct. Each and every one of you will leave a little bit of your heart here at Great Lakes today. And if you're as lucky as me, you can come back, and you can relive some of the moments that you lived here when you graduated boot camp today. You will realize how powerful it is to serve in our Navy. In closing, I would like to be the first to say to you, thank you for your service. I'm proud of you. I revere you. And I will cheer you. Congratulations. You are a nice six sailor.
Please remain seated until your graduates have been placed on liberty.
another round of appreciation for our wonderful musicians of Navy Band Great Lakes. Flags. Post. Section leaders. Fall out and retrieve outer garments. Without further delay, now hear this, Liberty Call!